The Minister of Information, ICT and National Guidance, Chris Waliomunsi, has warned all those that use social media that there are laws that are yet to be implemented to help in guiding the communication through the internet. The minister has highlighted that this has been brought about by the continued misuse of the social media.
Over the media space, which has included social media, which social media we should be using for positive communication, but there is a lot of abuse over the social media space, and we shall be coming up with relevant legislations to regulate social media so that we can use all these platforms for positive communication and for socio-economic transformation.
Honorable Waliomunsi was before Parliament this evening, where he was reading the National Report on Communication and Technology, as he showed what they have achieved, which includes stabilizing the network, reducing on the rates at which Ugandans purchase the internet, among others.
In line with the digital transformation program of the NDP3 and the objectives of the National Broadband Policy of 2018, the ICT sector has prioritized inclusive access to quality communication services prepared for us as a country to benefit from the developments and opportunities that ICTs present the development of our country and our citizenry. We are thus focused on improving coverage. We have already instructed NITAU, the National Information Technology Authority of Uganda, to work around the clock and address factors responsible for the high cost, and in the immediate term bring the cost to $30, and eventually we bring it $10 per megabyte per second, which is the international benchmark. So in the next few months it should be able to drop from 70 to 30.
However, some members of parliament have remained not satisfied with Honorable Waliomunsi's report on communications and technology. He has, however, promised that as government, they are to put more effort on the legislators' concerns.
Mobile phone feedback. Our voters have these small phones. Sometimes they call them cartouche. Really, these small phones for buttons. As they are calling us, you get a very rude feedback. Very rude feedback, and all these phones go through, you know, they are imported and brought in by, after being checked by your people. I wonder whether you're regulating the phone gadgets that, you know, are coming in.
Our networks are being managed from China. So right on our speaker, some of these kind of services we are talking about are very bad, because the people who are supposed to respond to network failures, We have a big time difference. There would be a network shutdown in Uganda, but the person who is supposed to maintain this is sleeping in China because the time is ahead. So, Andy, right on our speaker, this one also comes with a big security.
Wondering how somebody procures data, and within a minute they tell you the data has expired. So I'm not understanding, when was it manufactured? What is the shelf life that the internet should stay, and within no minute, and they tell you your internet has expired?
I want you at least to see how you can help border districts, especially Rutshiga, Kamwezi, Sabu County, where you can't even make a call.
He also hinted on the fact that even those that use VPN pay internet taxes.
Facebook, as a private operator, breached some of these conditions. And the discussions are ongoing between the UCC, the presenting government, and Facebook to harmonize and understand each other and ensure that the law and the guidelines which we have passed as a country are followed. Because whether you are a television or radio or online communication or social media, you must fit into the communications law which was passed by this parliament. But the discussions are ongoing between UCC and Facebook, and sooner than later, I think the discussion will conclude and then we return to the original position. But those using VPN are doing it irregularly. But I can assure you that even when you use VPN, you are not avoiding taxes. You still pay tax when you use VPN.
This story has been compiled by Issa Chigongo for Channel 44 Prime News.